Hi friends, we will discuss today accounting for partnership transactions, and we have to learn how we are going to account for certain transactions in the books of the partnership firm. Okay, today's agenda, or I am going to discuss these things for you. The first thing I am going to discuss is the partnership deed. What do you mean by the partnership deed? I am going to discuss the various methods of maintaining partner's capital account. Then we are going to learn the accounting treatment for interest on drawings, interest on capital of the partners, interest on loans and advances provided by the partners. We are going to discuss about salary and commission payable to the partners. We are going to learn how the profits are going to be shared by the partners. We are also going to learn about guaranteed profits to which a partner is entitled. Okay, so let us take our discussion step by step. The first topic which I want to discuss with you is the partnership deed. Now, before I discuss about the partnership deed, let us discuss the definition of a partnership firm or partnership. Now, as per the Partnership Act 1932, partnership is the relationship between two or more persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. This is the definition given by the Partnership Act 1932. I'll repeat it slowly once again for you. It is the relationship between persons who have agreed to share the profits or losses of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. Now, I stressed on the word agree. Why do I stress it on? Why do I stress on it? Agree. See, partnership is created by agreement. The agreement can be oral or it can be written. The Partnership Act nowhere specifies that it should be a written agreement or it should be an oral agreement. It says only an agreement. It's an agreement between persons, two or more persons. No. The Act does not specify whether the agreement should be in writing or whether it can be oral. But the Act has created certain limitations for unregistered partnership firms. No. When can a firm be registered? A firm can be registered only when a partnership deed is prepared and it is presented to the registrar of partnership for registration. Now that means only when the partnership agreement is in writing, the partnership can be registered. So, when the partners write down the terms and conditions of the partnership firm, that agreement is called as the partnership deed. Let us talk about what is generally contained in the partnership deed. In the partnership deed, the partners are going to write down what will be the name of the firm. We are also going to write down the address of the principal place of business of the firm, the names, addresses, occupation of the partners, amount of capital which the partners have agreed to contribute. Partners, are they entitled to draw money? This will also be handled in the partnership deed. Interest on drawings, interest on capital, interest on loans and advances provided by the partners, salary, remuneration, commission payable to the partners, books of accounts, sharing of profits, profit sharing ratio will also be provided in the partnership deed. Authorized signatory for the bank account. Who is going to operate the bank account? Powers, duties, responsibilities of the partners of the firm. Method of valuation of goodwill. Treatment of goodwill. Admission of a partner. Retirement of a partner. Death of a partner. Dissolution of the firm. We are going to write down whole bunch of things in a deed called as the partnership deed. So, partnership deed is created with a single intention that in the future there should not be any conflict. Partners should not start fighting on certain issues. That is why the partnership deed is registered. It is written and is registered with the registrar of partnership firms. Okay, so I think you now understand about the partnership deed. Now let us come into the next topic, methods of maintaining capital accounts. Now, the partner's capital account can be maintained under two methods. First method is called as the fixed capital method, and the other method is called as the fluctuating capital method. Now, what do you mean by the fixed capital method? What do you mean by the fluctuating capital method? Now, let us start with the fluctuating capital method. Under the fluctuating capital method of maintaining partner's capital account, now first of all, the question will be raised, where am I going to maintain the partner's capital account? Partner's capital account will be maintained in the books of the firm. The accountant of the firm has to maintain the partner's capital account. Now, under the fluctuating capital method, as I told you, there are two methods, fixed capital and fluctuating capital method. Under the fluctuating capital method, the accountant is going to maintain only one account for each partner. Now, if you are going to maintain only one account for each partner, the opening balance of the capital account is going to be shown in that account. If partner brings further capital into the business, it will be shown in the capital account. If partner is withdrawing money from the business, that is drawings, it will also be shown in the same capital account. If the partner is going to pay some interest on drawings, if the firm is going to charge interest on drawings, that is also going to be shown in the partner's capital account. If the partner is entitled to any salary, remuneration, commission as per the partnership deed, it will also be recorded in the partner's capital account. Share in profits or losses, it will also be recorded in the partnership, in the partner's capital account. Interest on loans, advances, that will also be recorded in the partner's capital account. See, when you are recording so many transactions in the same account, it is not possible for the account to show a fixed balance. It is going to fluctuate. That is why when you maintain only one account for each partner and all transactions of the partner are shown in the same account, let us say all these adjustments, interest on drawings, interest on capital, interest on loans, salary, share of profits, all these adjustments are shown in the same capital account, the capital balance keeps fluctuating. That is why that method is called as the fluctuating capital method. And this method, we maintain only one capital account, one account for each partner. That is called as the fluctuating capital method of maintaining the capital account. Now, the other method, the fixed capital method. Now, what do you mean by the fixed capital method? As the name suggests, the capital balance has to remain fixed. It cannot fluctuate. But as we have seen, there are going to be many adjustments to the partner's capital account. If there are so many adjustments to the partner's capital account, how can it remain fixed? So what the accountant does is, he is going to maintain two accounts. The first account is called as the partner's capital account, and the other account is called as the partner's current account. So he is going to maintain two accounts for each partner, partner's capital account and partner's current account. In the partner's capital account, we are going to show only the opening balance of capital from the last year, and if the partner has introduced some more capital during the year, that will be shown in the partner's capital account. Apart from these, no other transactions will be recorded in the partner's capital account. Now, what about drawings of the partner? What about interest on drawings? What about interest on capital? What about interest on loans in advance given by the partner? Share in profits, share in losses, where they have to be recorded? They will be recorded in a separate account called as the partner's current account. So partner's current account will keep fluctuating, but the partner's capital account will show a fixed balance because it is showing only the opening balance and only the capital which has been introduced during the year. So that is called as the fixed capital method. So on the fluctuating capital method, we have only one account for each partner. All the transactions are shown in the same account. But in the fixed capital method, we maintain two accounts. One is partner's capital account and the other account is called as the partner's current account. Okay, I think now the methods of maintaining capital account have become very clear for you. Now, let us take up the treatment of these issues in the books of the firm. Let us take up the first issue, interest on drawings. Now, before we continue, I would like to rub these things from the board so that we will have more space. Interest on drawings. No. Interest on drawings. First of all, what do you mean by drawings? When the owner introduces his personal cash into the business, when the owner introduces his personal assets into the business, we call it as capital contribution. When the owner withdraws cash from the business, or when the owner withdraws assets from the business, and he takes it away to his home, we call it as drawings. No. If the partner is going to withdraw the capital from the business will face a lot of problems. It will not have cash to meet his expenses. So, firms would like to create a barrier. They would like to stop the partners from withdrawing their capital because it will create liquidity problems. There will be no working capital for the firm to pay its expenses, salaries, rents, etc., to pay its creditors. So we have to stop the partners from withdrawing their capital. How it can be done? We have to create a roadblock. The roadblock is interest on drawings. So, in certain situations, partners will be charged interest by the firm on their drawings. So when the partners have withdrawn their capital, the firm can charge interest on those drawings. Now, the question comes, how much interest can the firm charge from the partners? Can the firm charge 12%? Can the firm charge 8%? Can the firm charge 6%? What is the rate? The answer is, only when the partnership deed clearly specifies the rate. If the partnership deed says 6%, the firm can charge 6% interest on drawings. If the partnership deed says 10%, then you can charge 10% interest on drawings. If the partnership deed is silent, then the firm has no authority to charge any interest on drawings made by the partners. So, before you write an entry for interest on drawings, before the accountant thinks of charging interest on the drawings by the partner, he has to read the partnership deed. If the partnership deed is silent, no interest can be charged. If the partnership deed provides for the rate of interest, then interest on drawings can be charged at the rate of interest given by the partnership deed. Okay, now here there are two concepts which I have to be clear about. When the partner withdraws his profits from the firm, interest is generally not charged because it is his right. The firm has earned profits, he is entitled to draw profits. Interest may not be charged. But when he is drawing his capital, definitely the partnership deed may provide for charging interest on drawings against capital. Okay, and the interest has to be charged only according to the rate which has been specified by the partnership deed. Now, interest on drawings is a loss for the partner, it is an income for the firm. How do you account for this? We are going to pass two entries for accounting for interest on drawings. The first entry we are going to pass when the interest on drawings is made due. The first entry we are going to pass is interest on drawings is an income for the firm. So we credit the interest on drawings to interest on drawings. Nominal account, incomes and gain for the firm. That account has to be credited. Whose account has to be debited? The partner is suffering the loss. That is why the partner's capital account or the partner's current account has to be debited. So we are going to pass the entry partner's capital account or partner's current account debtor. Partner's capital account should be debited and interest on drawings account should be credited in the books of the firm. Now, this is an income for the firm. It's a nominal account. It has to be closed down. So we are going to pass the second entry. The second entry we are going to pass is interest on drawings account debtor to profit and loss appropriation account. What do you mean by the profit and loss appropriation account? See, this is an account prepared by the partnership firm to make certain adjustments like interest on drawings, interest on capital, sharing of profits and losses. To complete these adjustments, the partnership firm will maintain an account called as the profit and loss appropriation account. The net profits from the P&L account are brought down to the profit and loss appropriation account, and after making adjustments for interest on drawings, interest on capital, salary to the partner, share in profits and losses, the remaining profits are transferred to the partner's capital account. So, when the interest is credited, this is credited, it is an income for the firm. This account has to be closed. That is why the account has been debited and it has been credited to an account called as the profit and loss appropriation account. So for accounting for interest on drawings, we are going to pass two entries. The first entry is when the interest is made due, the entry we are going to pass is partner's capital or current account data to interest on drawings account when interest is made due. And when the interest is transferred to the P&L appropriation account, we debit the interest on drawings account and we credit the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, so these are the two entries which we are going to pass for interest on drawings. Now the question comes, how do you calculate interest on drawings? There should be some amount for which we have to pass the entry. How are you going to calculate this amount? The calculation is very, very simple. You have to find out how much amount was withdrawn by the partner, and you have to calculate interest from the date of drawing up to the date of preparation of your financial statements. On the day when you are preparing your P&L appropriation account, as on the last date of your accounting year, you have to calculate interest. It is from the date of drawing up to the last date in the accounting period, you are going to charge interest on the drawings. Okay, the formula will be very simple. It will be amount of drawing into rate of interest multiplied by the unexpired period divided by 12 or 365. It is the amount of drawing multiplied by the rate of interest given in the partnership deed, then unexpired period divided by 12 or 365. Now what do you mean by unexpired period? It is the gap between the date of drawing up to the date of preparation of your financial statement. That is the last date of preparing your financial statement. We are going to calculate interest on drawings using this formula. Okay, there are certain complexities involved in calculation of interest on drawings. We'll take it up later as we proceed. We are going to take up even the complex transactions relating to interest on drawings. So I'll summarize. Interest on drawings. Partnership firm can charge interest on drawings against capital. Generally, interest on drawings against profits are not charged. Drawings against profits cannot charge interest. And how much interest has to be charged? Interest has to be charged at the rate provided by the partnership deed. So the accountant does not have the freedom to fix the rate. It is the partnership deed that will provide for the rate. If the partnership deed is silent, the firm cannot charge any interest on drawings. And what are the entries you pass? The entries are here for you, and you should have also noted down, and this will be a lot of help for your ensuing exam. So we have completed the discussion on interest on drawings. Let us take up the next topic. Salaries, commission. Interest on drawings was a income for the firm, but salaries and commission payable to the partner is an expense for the firm. See, I think we may already know that we have different types of partners, active partners. What do you mean active partner? Who takes active part in day-to-day management of the firm? No. There are certain partners who spend full time working for the firm. They would like to get some salary. They would like to get some commission from the firm because of their hard work which they have put in for the welfare of the firm or for the benefit of the firm, for the success of the firm. No. How much salary should be paid to the partners, or how much commission should be paid to the partners? Let us say Ram and Kareem are partners, or Ram and Rahim are partners in the firm. Ram is working very hard for the partnership firm. He comes to the office at 8 o'clock in the morning. He works up to 8 o'clock in the evening, and he doesn't take Sundays or Saturdays as leave. He works 24 hours. He works for 365 days during the year from 8 o'clock in the morning up to 8 o'clock in the evening. He says, I am entitled to 25,000 rupees per month salary, or I am entitled to 30,000 rupees per month salary. Can he pay that? Is he entitled to that much amount of salary? The answer is, it is not the wish and will of the partner to decide the salary which he can claim. The partner is entitled to claim only the amount of salary which is provided by the partnership deed. If the partnership deed is silent, partners do not have any authority to claim any salary. They cannot claim any commission for the extra effort which they have put in for the partnership firm. So partners cannot claim salary if it is not provided in the partnership deed. Even if they do lot of hard work, they are not entitled. So we have to read the partnership deed to find out whether the partners are entitled to claim salary or commission. Now we have to discuss one more point. The most important point is salary and commission are appropriation of profits. They are not charges against profits. Now, what do you mean by appropriation and what do you mean by charges? Appropriation. See, if the firm has profits, lot of profits it has, in such cases, salary may be allowed to the partner. If the partner, if the partnership firm is in losses, there are no profits, in such a situation, no salary will be paid to the partners. That means salary and commission will be paid only out of profits. Out of profits, that means only when profits are available, salary and commission will be paid. If the firm has losses or the firm is not doing well, in such situations, even though the partnership deed provides for it, the firm, the partners are not entitled to claim any salary or remuneration or even commission for the work done by them. So salary and commission is an appropriation of profits. It is not a charge against profits. How much salary can be claimed? As provided by the partnership deed. Now, salary to the partner is an expense for the firm. How do you account for it? There are two entries which we are going to pass. The first entry is salaries account data to partners capital or current account. We are going to debit salaries account, we are going to credit partners capital or current account. So when salary is made due, this is entry we pass. It is nominal account expense and loss debit, and these are the people who are entitled to the salary, so their capital account is credited. The second entry, this account has to be closed. It is a nominal account, it has to be closed. How do you close it? Credit that account. So we are going to credit salaries account and we are going to debit the profit and loss appropriation account. So we are going to pass the second entry, P&L appropriation account data to salaries. So we are going to pass two entries, when salary is made due, salaries account data to partners capital account, and when it is transferred to P&L appropriation account, we pass the entry P&L appropriation account data to salaries. So account is debited, account is credited, this account get closed, P&L appropriation account is debited. Okay. So these are the two entries which we are going to pass. So I think the treatment of salaries and commission would have become very clear in your mind. If there are sufficient profits, we can pay salaries and commission. If the profits are not there, then you cannot claim any salaries or commission. If there are insufficient amount of profits, only the amount of available profits can be claimed as salary or commission. But when there are losses, there is no chance partners will not get any salary or commission. See, the logic behind this is very simple. In the case of a partnership firm, partners can claim only share in profits. They are not entitled to anything else. If you are going to pay them anything else, that is nothing but an indirect way of sharing your profits. That is why even salaries and commission are indirect way of sharing profits to the partners. That is why only to the amount of available profits, salaries and commissions can be paid. If there are no profits, they cannot be. We have come to the discussion. Let us take up the next topic. Interest on capital. Third topic is interest on capital. Are the partners entitled to claim any interest on the capital contributed by them? Is the question which we are going to take up for discussion. Can the partners claim interest on capital? The answer is, partners can claim interest on their capital only when the partnership deed clearly provides for it. If the partnership deed is silent, partners cannot claim even a single rupee as interest on their capital. So when the partnership deed provides, pay interest to the partners on their capital, we have to pay interest on capital. If the partnership deed is silent, then there is no question of paying any interest to the partners on their capital. Okay, now how much interest on capital has to be paid? Question is very simple. How much interest we have to pay to the partners on their capital? This is the question. Answer is very simple. The answer is, we have to read the partnership deed to find out the rate of interest which the partners can claim as interest on their capital. If the partnership deed is silent, partners do not have any authority to claim any interest on capital. Interest on capital is again an expenditure for the firm. It's an expense for the firm. No, it is again an appropriation of profits. It is not a charge against profits. That means only when the firm has profits, the partnership firm will pay interest on capital provided by the partners. When the partnership has no profits or the partnership is in losses, in such situation, the firm need not pay any interest on capital to the partners, even though it is provided in the partnership deed. If, so I'll repeat it again, if the firm has profits, we can pay interest on capital according to the partnership deed. If the firm has zero profits or if it is in losses, no interest on capital has to be paid, even if the partnership deed provides for it. The third situation is, the firm is having profits, but the profits are insufficient. In such case, the available amount of profits have to be shared in the capital ratio. We have to share it in what ratio? The capital ratio of the partners. Okay? Now, interest on capital is an expense for the firm. It is something, it is a gain for the partners. How do you account for it in the books of accounts of the firm? The accounting part, interest on capital is an expense for the firm. So, you pass the entry. Interest on capital account debtor to partners capital or current account credit. It's an expense for the firm, nominal account expense loss debit. And because of this expense, it's an expense for the firm, but it's going to benefit the partners. So their capital account is credited. So when the interest is made due, we are going to pass the entry interest on capital account or partners capital or current account. When interest on capital is transferred to the P&L appropriation account, we are going to pass the entry P&L appropriation account debtor to interest on capital account credit. This account is debited, this account is credited, this account is closed, and P&L appropriation account is debited with the interest on capital. Partners capital account and partners current account are credited. So this is the discussion on interest on capital. I'll repeat it again once for you. Interest on capital will be paid to the partners only when it is provided to the partnership deed. If the partnership deed is silent, no interest on capital can be paid to the partners. And interest on capital is an appropriation of profits. It is not a charge against profits. That means only when profits are available, you can pay interest on capital. If there are zero profits or losses, no interest on capital will be paid to the partners. If there are insufficient profits, profits are there, but the amount of profits is very less, it's not sufficient to pay full amount of interest. In such cases, the whatever amount of profits are available, you have to share it in the capital ratio of the partners. Okay? And you have to remember this very important point. Generally, you calculate the interest on capital only on the opening balances of capital account. You have to calculate on the opening balances. Okay? So, this is how we treat interest on capital. Let us take up the next topic for discussion. Interest on loans and advances. A partner has given loans and advances to the firm over and above the capital contributed by him. He has given a loan to the firm. Firm needed money. He gave a loan to the firm. He gave some advance to the firm. Can he charge interest to the firm? Can he ask the firm to pay any interest to him? The answer is yes. The partner has the